Please get seated quickly. We're going to start our next session very soon. All right. Again, I'll briefly introduce myself. My name is David Wu. I'll be the host for the next four Android sessions this afternoon. The first speaker for the first session is Imamura-san. Imamura-san is the coordinator of the Future System Working Group of hold on a second. Open Embedded Software Foundation. Okay, he's also one of the starting members of the biggest Android community group in Japan. Today he's going to talk to us about one of the recent projects that he's working on. It's called the Auto Chasing Turtle, and it's using a Kinect sensor to detect faces. And the robot, after finishing detecting a face, the robot would go about chasing that person who is detected. So I think it sounds like a pretty interesting project. So let's welcome Imamura-san.
My name is Noritsuna Imamura. Nice to meet everybody. No response. Mr. Wu introduced about me. I cut my introduced part. Today, I speak about this auto chasing turtle. This is a robot which we made. Our team is called Ciprop Project. I have a pointer. This is Ciprop Project. This is a small open source project. Our members are three people. We have made a lot of fun things. This is one of them. Next, these are today's agenda. Today's material is separated three parts, summary and software and hardware. First part is summary. I will show a demo and explain about why we made this product. Second part, software. I will explain how to make this robot. This robot software and about Kinect. I explain Kinect this part. The important things are 3 points. Detect face, and calculate the course, and calculate the distance. Take a picture. And third part is hardware. I explain about robot controlling. This part has only one important thing. It's easy thing, but it's troublesome. next, start. Summary. This product. It's an auto chasing turtle. This product uses a Kinect and robot and a big robot. First, please watch the demo video. Sorry, I don't have this robot. Have only video. In fact, I was going to bring this robot in this seminar, but it is in the airplane now because it was inspected by a customs clearance. Sorry, I can't bring it. A show video. Sorry, no sound. Hey, too fast. Hey, this is explanation of this robot things. Hey. Next demonstration part. Hey, starting robot, hey, and rotate and looking for a human. Hey, robot find a human. Hey, this model is my friend's son. Hey, he's 5 years old. I can't read it. Sorry. Hey. Robot behavior. Subtitle is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7. Please read quickly. I uploaded a video and this material and source code. This URL. If you don't remember this URL, please search for Google. Use this keyword, auto-chasing turtle. Maybe you can find these pages. Why this project? Why did I make it? Because this project is one of Denske project. Denske project making a cyber pet robot for healthcare. This project is big. We must develop a lot of new technologies. Example, BMI, robotics, and mobile technologies. Therefore, we are making new technologies, little by little. This project is one of them. My turtle's project is one of them. About Denske project. This project is one of working groups, OESF. OESF is my non-profit organization. This working group is called a Future Working Group. This working group has a partner relationship program. This circle. This company is a robotics company and embedded company, chip company, and a cloud technology companies. They are starting members. Now it's getting larger. I don't know, now it's all members. Maybe over 20 members. This project leader, Mr. Otsuki, he was Ivo project director. This is Ivo. Ivo is the first pet robot for customer. Made by Sony. It was released 10 years ago. Do you know Ivo? No response. This is famous pet robot. Next. Next software part. About OVX Droid Kinect. This product we made. This software is a separate three part. Open frameworks and Kinect and Android. I explain the detail. First, open frameworks. It is media art framework. If you use it, you can make a product for media art easily. And this framework was explained by Mr. Huang maybe before conference in this event. If you want to know more detail, please ask him. Don't ask me. Okay? Second, Kinect. We use it as sensor. It is as an eye by RGB camera and DIPS camera. Therefore, I made a camera driver for Kinect. Third, Android. We used it as platform. Open frameworks run on Android. This robot is autonomous moving. We need to run by battery. We use save space computer. About two. This is an Android framework which has Open Frameworks API and Kinect APIs. We made it to combine three things: Open Frameworks for Android, Linaro Android kernel driver. By this, you can make media art programs easy, and battery operated is possible because we use Linaro Android. Linaro is an open source project. They make a Linux kernel for ARM board and porting to Android. This kernel uses ARM CPU because this board save power. Next, this part is a Kinect part. I explain three things: detect the face, calculate the course, and calculate the distance. Detect face. Important things, 2 points. How to get a Kinect camera's image and how to recognize a human's face. I explained more detail. How to get camera image. RGB camera's image, bitmap image, standard format. It's a 1 inch and a separate 4 part or 8 bit, a alpha and red, green, blue. But Kinect's RGB camera's low format is 3 inch, 32 bit R and 32 bit G and 32 bit B. This is a crazy format. past, I used a this format a bitmap, but all image tool can't read this format, and I make a converter for a Kinect RGB camera to bitmap format. Next, how to recognize a human face? This is source code. Just two lines. In fact, this is Android APIs. In fact, first I thought to use OpenCV. Which is in open frameworks, but it is necessary a lot of memory to use OpenCV. But a BeagleBot has not enough memory to run OpenCV. That's why I use this function. However, this function is too slow and but recognizing acceptable rate. If I make a next version a no robot, I'll use OpenCV and make an original algorithm for face detect. Because currently ARM's board have more memory than BeagleBot. I can use OpenCV now. I made this robot 8 months ago. Then I couldn't get more memory board. Next, calculate the course. What I do is only two things. Calculate center position of face. And calculate the position of the face from four sections, separation Kinect image. This is a four separate. And if a face position is a 400 point, and this image a 640 pixel, separate a 4 by 4, one part is a 106 pixel. If a face point is 400 pixel, this point is first, second, third section. In the case a robot is center, it don't to run. And if it's a first or a fourth section, a robot turn to right or left position. Okay, this is calculate the course algorithm, very easy. This source code is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8, 9 lines. Next, calculate the distance. Measure depth of a specified point from the center position of face by using Kinect. Robot walk forward to a back. Depending on the measured distance. Kinect has this function. If you put a argument a center point of face, you can get this point distance. And this code is if under 100, this robot is back. If 100 to 150, toward to 4, walk to 4 foot, and 8, 16, 32. This code is very easy. Next, hardware part. I have no enough time. This part is this part. How to control the robot? To control the robot is only to control servo angle. This servo angle. Example: if you want to move in front. In front. You walk. What do you do? Maybe you move your leg, your front. So this thing and to control servo's angle are same thing. Sorry. I delete walking image. This image. Hey. And because the joint is a servo's shaft. And muscle is a servo's torque. This one. So shaft and torque are angle. Servo's four parameters. These have a reversible relation. If you want more recursion velocity, if have to more serve quickly. By it reason, it control actually become hardly. This is a reversible relation. And this is reversible relation. Next, how to control servo. This board is a servo control unit. To control servo need a four step. Send to initial message, back arc, and send to control command, back arc. This is control message. Then, please consider that people tumble. When you tumble, maybe you move another leg in the front. It's the same thing, this image. You move a hip joint and knee joint and leg joint. Then you have to move some joint quickly. If you operate the joint servo in order, it's not quickly, you will tumble on the floor. Therefore, you have to control joints at the same time. And this board can control all servo by one command. That's why you need about this control board. This is very important thing. I explain about it time up. Next. This page is last page. This IC is a acceleration sensor. How do you recognize tumbling? Maybe you use a bioacceleration sensor within your brain. Then you calculate by your brain how if you move, you will not tumble. And you send some control command to your body, leg and your knee. Yeah. A robot is also things. But the main computer calculates other important things. If you need to use a lot of sensors, it can't calculate them. Therefore, the robot needs a board only for servo control and alerts, etc. board, besides the main computer. And this is one of the most important things to design and make robot. It's over. That's all.